everybody. Dignitaries in the dais, members of the faculty of the New Delhi Institute of Management, and the hordes of graduates, I would say, the management graduates who are now going to be the managers in the world. You just heard Mr. Bhulnani. He rattled off from his experience. And he made a very pertinent point that he was only a graduate who did not have the privilege of going through management, formal management education. I too joined him. I just was a graduate when I joined Bank of India as a probationary officer. But believe me, these 40 years of experience, I stand in front of you as a banker who has gone through the thick and thin of banking. I joined Bank of India after a lovely stint at Bank of America. It was a plunge, a conscious plunge which I had taken. And believe me, the public sector has a lot to offer in terms of bandwidth, in experience. And I must say that my decision has indeed been very rewarding, because having joined as an officer to reach the position of a chairman of a bank, it certainly means that you have gone through the rough and tumble of banking, and you finally achieve what is called the pinnacle in your career. I'm privileged to be amidst you at this 14th annual convocation of New Delhi Institute of Management. It is indeed a significant day, as it marks the happy ending of your dreams to secure a management qualification from an esteemed institution. I congratulate all of you for successfully completing the course, which you will utilize as a launch pad to address to enter the professional world and assume greater responsibilities. I also congratulate all the faculty members and your parents who have tirelessly and ceaselessly contributed to the successful culmination of your academic and professional desires. Now onwards, you enter the corporate jungle and a wicked world. Your skills at combining management and ethics, Mr. Bhulnani made a concluding remark that you should grow, but grow with ethics. Your skills at combining management and ethics would be put to test continuously, and it is here that ethics and value systems play a pivotal role. Life in the future and your professional career would be characterized by what is called group quotient. Today's world is borderless, and the new economy is a continent. Resultantly, the world holds as much panic as it does the promise of opportunity and productivity. We are in many ways facing the economic equivalent of what is called a perfect storm. Ethics and values are long-term investments to make a success in this era of turbulence management. From a caterpillar to a butterfly, the corporate caterpillar goes through what is called a metamorphosis. First it goes blind, then its arms and legs fall off, and finally its body splits open to allow beautiful wings to emerge. So would be your personal progress in the corporate jungle. It is a constant guerrilla warfare. Let not your professional lives be like biting chewing gum. After the initial excitement is over, you continue to only chew and chew and chew. Passion and commitment are vital ingredients here, and they have no expiry date. As a manager, your capabilities will be tested more by your being able to influence rather than control. Towards this end, your passion for learning, listening, and communicating would play a dominant role. First things first. All of you have already gone through the selection process. All of you are already in jobs. And to those of you who are already in jobs, the question would be whether I'm in the right job. I would only state, every job is a golden pot of water. The pot is the salary that pays our bills and the designation that pleases our desire to feel significant. But each job is potentially an opportunity to grow intellectually and emotionally. Each job contains the seed of learning that can germinate in our minds, if we allow it to. Unfortunately, jobs are seen more in economic terms, the pot, than in learning terms, the water. Any professional who sees his work primarily as a means of earning money runs out of its meaning very soon.